Hello everyone and welcome. Sometimes in boat life, it's down to the captain to make that final call. Ross goes with his gut and changes our plan again. But where do we end up? In a little piece of paradise. Leave us a comment, and if you're new here, please like, subscribe, and smash that bell for more videos. This one is so happy.
Come and have a cuddle.
Are you dreaming?
What do you think?
No, it's so good.
What is it? How are you feeling?
I'm so happy now.
You're happy. She's back. We're going to give her a facelift today, aren't we?
For a little wash.
This is what we're leaving today. Stunning Chinusa. But we've got about 10 hours. 12 hours of sailing ahead of us. Searching for something that ain't lost. God, our lines cross. We're wasting time on stuff that doesn't really matter, while wishing for something better.
Morning, guys. So I've not had much to say this morning. I'm feeling pretty knackered, and I've got that butterfly feeling in my stomach where anyone who's probably passed the Morgos before will understand. I'm hoping this coffee will help. Thanks, Laura, for making that this morning. I'll probably be awake in an hour or so. Maybe you don't want to know, but you don't see what you have in front of you. Just saw a dolphin, guys. Yeah, over here. I know, it's late.
It's not always easy being a captain. And when you're sailing with a family, you have their lives, their comfort, and all of these things to consider. And on this day, I can't describe the feeling I felt, but my instincts were saying, do not do this crossing today. As we left some of the shelter from Koufonisi, the conditions were already up, and this is only 7 a.m. As unpredictable as the Meltemi is, as a guide, the Meltemi blows from 9 till 5, increasing throughout the day. And where the sea fetch is about 250 miles, the main stream of the Meltemi is funneled between Ikaria and Mykonos, and the big steep waves that hit the north coast of Amorgos, causing a confused sea state. This is not a crossing to be taken lightly. It's hard to know the difference between following your instincts and giving in to fear. But my way of looking at it is fear is irrational.
Oh, what? I don't think she realises I've already turned around.
Don't have glass on deck. Whoops.
So gonna
have to wear yachts now. I've had a whole 4 feet yacht. We don't want that going on the floor, do we?
Look at this gorgeous little spot. Oh, breathe a sigh of relief that we're not crossing the Amorgos today. Lovely sleepy little spot. Thank goodness for that. Me and Poppy are both very relieved about this decision.
Yes, I am. I really, really don't want to end up on a rock again. I've had quite enough stress for 1 month. You ain't helping me at all.
Yeah. The memories, they all twist and turn. I'm not happy, I'm really happy.
ferry. This is a gorgeous place.
It's like beautiful. I think I'm having a rent here.
You are, that's good.
It looks so cute.
A few hours later, and I did not regret that decision. And hey, Koufonisi is a beautiful island.
Enjoying the last bit of this beautiful place, but time to go soon.
Right, Matt.
Ross is having a bit of a pickle with his hair. It's all matted, isn't it?
I was hoping you were going to do it.
Well, if you let me eat my dinner, I might.
It's in left, right, centre.
Yeah, well, guess what? I'm not doing anything until I've had my dinner because I'm starving. I'm useless when I'm hungry. I got the answer to all your problems. Let's do it. There we go, monsieur. That'll be £50, please.
The next day, we decided to head south to Kato Koufonisi to seek shelter from some even stronger winds that were about to head our way.
Come to hide! Ross has gone spearfishing. And I am having what's otherwise known as a pinch me moment. Look at this, I'm a little bit blown away. It's one of those moments where you just think, this is actually our life. There's Ross right there. Let me know you want it too. Don't you on this boat, doing what we love with the people we love on the Greek islands. It's just insane. And I just had a bit of a moment because, I don't know, sometimes you just don't stop and really realise what you're doing. It's a dream come true. I've had a very good day today.
What Laura didn't know is I was actually looking for suitable rocks for shorelines as I was planning to take Holly's stern 2 to the rocks. In theory, this will give us better shelter. I often check the depth by holding myself upright, and if my fins touch the floor, then the keel will touch the floor. Obviously, I wouldn't recommend this in tidal areas like the UK.
We're committed. We're going stern 2. It's so incredible here. Stern 2, in our own little bit of paradise. Amazing. We are 2 miles away from any kind of civilization. Water is beautiful. But I don't know if you can see, but the boat is doing this. So it's going to be interesting at night. It's definitely true, you can't have it all. You really can't have it all. But you can have a lot of it. So on our subject of pirates, we are currently putting together 3 pirate insults a day. We've got like a little list on the wall. You get a start, a middle and an end word. And we've come up with some crackers. What's yours, Noah?
Put your pocket up while I crack him. You filled sucking scabby sea bass. Your pox face black spotted bilge rat.
Well done! That's quite a mouthful.
Oh yeah.
I'm meditating.
Do you feel like you're on a boat? How are we doing, first mate?
Oh, amazing. I've had a new shave. I'm about to go and explore in the canoe. Right guys, I'm gonna take you with me. Let's go for a little paddle and a stomp.
See you later, darling.
Oh no, she's broke it.
Pin's broke.
Oh no!
Oh.
I don't know what that was.
That was the spring.
Would have held it on.
If anyone knows how those things work, they'll understand. She doesn't know where she's going.
Cheerio!
Bye! I thought you were going this way.
I don't know where I'm going at the moment. I'm going over there, I think.
Want to finish our game of Monopoly?
Yep.
This is just incredible. Holly's back there. You can see. Guys, this is so beautiful. I'm really, really excited. The water is pristine and you can see just like white sand all at the bottom of it. It's like being in the Maldives or something. It's absolutely amazing. Let's go that way. Kato Koufonisi is an uninhabited island. And it sits just off the south of Koufonisi Island. Very easy to access, all you gotta do is get a ferry. You can probably see one over there now in the distance. There's ferries running all the time from Koufonisi, and I think probably from islands like Eos and Chanusa as well. We've got a bit of swell going on, by the way, guys. So this is quite common for me, you guys, when I have work to do, or maybe I'm feeling a little bit fibro-y. My fibromyalgia is playing up a little bit. I just get off, go for a walk, get my endorphins going, and I generally tend to send my best coaching messages when I'm in this frame of mind as well. Walking is just good for everything. I can't show you that. That is so funny, guys. We are in the middle of nowhere, absolute middle of nowhere, and there's a nude man on the beach. They're everywhere. Definitely more inhabited than I thought. This is gonna stay a secret because if Ross knows that there's a way of getting beer on the island, then he won't go. So I think I'll keep this one under wraps. This is the monastery area, I think. Oh, cute. Wow, I think I found Ross's stash. Someone's been having a good time. That is Ross over there. He's on the tender and he's got my canoe. I can see. Cheeky bugger. Hello, mate. Aww. Hello, cutie. Here he is in my canoe.
Don't throw stones at them. They're just interested in you. That's all. How are we doing, cave boy? They're quite funny, aren't they? Mummy's off to do dinner. Seems to be quite an important thing to do right now. All aboard. What's going on, guys?
We're having a welcome home pie for Poppy because
she's home.
She's been rescued.
So I managed to find some wrapping paper. The only wrapping paper on the boat that's got trolls all over it. So somebody must have bought a present at some point. Thank you, whoever you are, because you've provided a tablecloth. We've got some old decorations that we made, some streamers, balloons.
Welcome home.
And the boat's definitely rocking.
Yeah, the party is rocking, literally.
Literally.
I'm not sure
whether I'm going to hold on to the wall.
Might have to cut loose tonight and go swinging anchor at some point, or something other than this. So I'm just trying to cook it. And Noah got 28 out of 30 on his maths today, so I'm really, really, really impressed with him. And we're having a presentation party, aren't we? So you guys are getting your certificates today, aren't you?
Yeah.
And you'll find out what they are in a minute.
Why did the old man fall in the well?
I don't know.
Because he couldn't see that well.